for the Judgment Day play, written and directed by yours truly, Delinda K. Graves, from God's Plan Drama Ministries. We hope you enjoy the show, and we thank you for coming out to see us. Enjoy!
Your best friend. Plus, I always know when you're lying because you bite your lip. It's Maurice, isn't it? What have you done this time?
I don't want to talk about it.
Well, Paulette girl, you have to talk about it. You can't keep it bottled up inside.
I know. It's just that Maurice has been really distant lately, and I'm not sure what I'm doing wrong. I mean, I'm giving him 100% in this relationship, and he's only giving me 10, which I think is crazy.
Well, I have a solution.
Oh, Lord, what is that?
I mean, let me ask you this. How bad do you want to be with Maurice? I mean, are you willing to do anything?
Teresa, you know I want to be with Maurice.
Have you heard of Miss Bumper?
Miss Bumper? Who is that?
She's a witch doctor.
Oh, no, no, no. I am not getting involved with that.
Well, I think you should at least try it. I mean, you told me yourself God hasn't been answering any of your prayers.
Well, how do you know that going to Miss Bumper will work?
Because Kim told me she went for Tyrone and now he's glued to her hip. I mean, I think that's great.
Well, if it's so great, why are you single?
Girl, that's besides the point. I love having a different man every day, as well as a handful of sugar daddies whenever I call. Girl, you only want one man, and I know Miss Bumper can help you.
I don't know about this, Teresa.
Girl, go get dressed.
I better not regret this.
You won't. Now go get dressed. You know you take all day.
Whatever.
Girl. Kevin, with your fine self, we could have got married and had some babies.
What are you doing in here, girl?
Looking at this picture of your brother, Kevin. Girl, he was fine.
He was a looker, wasn't he? Too young for you, though. Now, come on before I change my mind. And plus, Miss Bumper is probably closed by now.
Girl, Miss Bumper ain't got no clothes now. She always open.
Of course.
Come on, baby.
Give me something that he has given to you.
All I have is this ring he gave.
Give it to me.
Give it to her.
Now! This man has hurt you, yet you want him to be in your life? Are you sure? Are you sure he's the one?
Yes, I'm sure. And I know if he'll help you, he will turn around and he will do right.
Ew, girl, have you cleaned that ring lately?
Be quiet, Teresa.
Listen very carefully for the instructions I'm about to give to you. I want you to take this and make Maurice a cake. He doesn't have to eat the whole thing, just a piece. But make sure that no one else eats of this cake.
Okay, but why?
Because if they do, they will die.
Oh my gosh, I'll make sure no one else eats of the cake.
Lee, your time here is up.
That's it, and he's gonna fall in love with me?
Get!
You don't mind, do you? I'll look out for you when you get here. All right. That's cool.
Hey, Mama. How are you today?
Paula, don't be coming here making all that noise. Don't you see me on the phone over here? God.
No, I'm not with Teresa. Have Maurice called me?
I didn't know dogs could talk.
Quiet, Mark. Go home and mind your business.
No, he ain't called her. Why are you so obsessed with this man that has hurt you so bad?
Whatever, Mama. Do we have any eggs?
We may have a few left. What on earth do you need eggs for?
All right. What is this?
Oh, my gosh, Mama. Be careful with this.
What are you going to do with a jar of honey water, Paula?
I need it for my
I know you didn't say Miss Bumper.
Yes, Miss Bumper, do you know her?
Yes, I know Seth Bumper. She's been practicing witchcraft in this neighborhood for years. You know, when your daddy and I were younger, she tried to get me to do a spell on him. Paula, leave this stuff alone. You know, if you and Maurice were meant together, Mark 10 and 9 says, therefore, what God has joined together, let no man put asunder. I don't want to have anything to do with this, Paula. Who told you about Sis Bumper's influence?
Teresa.
That is. Teresa ain't had a serious relationship in years. And right now, she's got 5 or 6 different men.
5 or 6?
Got a new Paula. Paula, don't mess with this stuff. You're going to have to get that curse right out of my house, Paula. You know, the Bible tells us in Ezekiel 14:7, turn your faces away from evil and touch no unclean thing, and I will receive you.
Mama, I need somewhere to make this cake. You are overreacting as usual. Have you ever heard someone die of witchcraft?
No, I haven't. But in Revelations 21:8, it says, the fearful, the unbelieving, the abominable, murderous, the poor ones, the sorcerers, which is Miss Bumper, all liars and adulterers will have their place in the lake which burns with fire and brimstone. Now, baby, I'm trying to keep myself on the straight and narrow. Because one day, you're going to look at me and I'm going to die.
Mama, I know you have to die.
I'm not talking about dying. I'm talking about being part of the rapture with my Lord. Paula, don't mess with this stuff. I'm telling you right now, you know, in the Bible it says plainly, do not seek out mediums and networks. Don't even turn your faces to them.
Mama, I'm so tired of you doing this to me. Why?
Apologize. I want you to be safe from messing with that stuff. Now, I'm just sitting down. You know that, Mom. I'm sick of all this.
Mom, I hear what you were saying, but whether you like me doing this or not, I'm going to do this thing. And Maurice, he will be mine.
Huh? Well, it looks like you have made your decision to follow Satan, isn't it? You might as well get out of that door right now. I'm not going to welcome
Satan
to my house. You need to leave right now.
Fine, I'll leave you. You don't have to worry about me crashing your front door ever again. Get off of me, Mark. Leave me alone.
Don't go, Paula.
I'm sure. Everything's all right, son.
What's wrong with her, Mama?
Lord have mercy.
There she go. I think that's her name. She came.
Oh, come
Excuse me. Mom? Is somebody here gonna see you?
I got it, Mom. Let me get this. She just a friend, Mom. Don't worry. Go sit down.
Down to business, son.
What you doing coming to my mother's house like this? Do you got my money?
No, I have it tomorrow, man. I need my check tomorrow.
You gonna wish you had my money, Mom. Boy. Hey, get out of here. Don't come back out here, Mom. You all right, Mama?
Mom? Don't tell me you did what I thought you did and had the audacity to do it on my front porch.
See, Mom, it's not what you think. It's not what you think.
Well, what did you sell her then? Because it certainly wasn't milk. Mom, before you lie to me again, you're going to get out of this house and take those drugs right with you.
Look, Mom, I'm your son. You can't do this to your son.
Yeah, you're my son, Mark. Do you remember when you were 8 years old, your father died?
Yeah.
I told you the day of the funeral, Mom, your dad is gone now, but your heavenly father is going to be with you always. I even taught you the Ten Commandments so that if you knew, kept them, you would not err. Son, you selling those drugs is terrible and is of the devil. I didn't raise you like that, Mom. You know, in Ezekiel 14:6, it says, come out from among them, repent, says the Lord, and turn your faces from your abominations, and I will receive you. And then it says in Romans 6:23, for the wages of sin is death, but the gift of God is eternal life through Jesus Christ our Lord. Mark, where you going? Listen to me, Mark. This last one, don't you ever forget it. Sit down, son.
Mama, come on, man.
This will take you to the end of your grave. The Bible clearly says, if we confess our sins, that he is faithful and just to forgive us and cleanse us of all our unrighteousness. Mark, whenever you feel it down, feel like you're going to give up, just look up to heaven, son, and say these words.
There is power in the name of Jesus. There is power in the name of Jesus. To break every chain, break every chain, break every chain.
Son, give it to Jesus, son.
Mama, I'm not ready for all that. I'm just not ready for all that.
Mark.
I'll talk to you later,
please,
Mom.
Please, Mark.
I gotta go, Mom.
Don't leave, Mark. Please, don't leave.
I'll talk to you later, Mom.
Oh, Lord, please, help. Jesus, Lord, let's place our hands to you. Not only help my love, Lord God, please don't take your hands from me, Lord God, without a word I will go. Lord, I want to thank you, Father God, for keeping me all through these years. Thank you, Lord, for watching over me, my children. And Lord, right now I'm asking you to feel a sense of realm, Lord God. Keep them from all hurt from the tension. Send your angel, Father God, to protect us. And Lord, help them to turn back to you, Lord God, the glory we can be together in your kingdom someday, Lord God. Lord, I ask you.
better do it. Oh, snap. That's what I'm talking about, baby. Right there, right there. That's what I'm talking about. Not right now, not right now. Right. Look, don't come in here with all that, okay? I've been busy. Don't you see the game, Mom?
So what's been going on, Maurice? Why have you been ignoring me? Is it someone else?
Oh, man, that's not it. Dang.
Well, anyway, since your birthday is Sunday, I made you a little cake.
All right, cool. I'll get some after dinner, I guess.
So, I mean, what in the world is it, Maurice? It's time for us to get our life together and stop living in fornication and get married.
What? Look, man. If I want to marry you, all right? I'll marry you. Don't touch my TV. Hey, don't touch my TV.
Now, let's stop. Let's stop.
Look, I already told you, man. If I want to marry you, I'll marry you, all right? But ain't nobody going to push me to it, and that's that.
Calm down.
Put my TV on.
Calm down. I'm not trying to push you into doing anything. It's just I know we're living wrong in God's eyes. My mama always told me that the Bible said that it's better to marry than burn. And she also told me, a man that finds a wife, finds a good thing.
Look, first of all, you was not my wife, right? As a matter of fact, you can bag up and stop coming up in here with all that God stuff. All right? Because I'm sitting here, I'm trying to figure out, right? That God stuff, you heard what I said? You coming up in here, you trying to preach to me. And your lifestyle don't even match up with what you saying. You and your friend Teresa, y'all step in the club, or somebody party turned up, then all of a sudden you want to come up here, you want to talk godly? Hey, you better get out of here.
Are you serious?
Yeah.
You don't see that I'm trying to share that lifestyle and be a good wife to you, Maurice?
Ain't nobody trying to hear that. Look here, all right? You get yourself right, all right? Get yourself right first, and then you come and try to tell me what I'm doing wrong. Because only God can judge me, sweetheart. Only God can. So take a seat.
You gonna wish you would have listened one day.
Alright. I don't wanna go there. Oh, we should never go there. Yeah. I don't wanna go there. But I guess I gotta go there. Cause you're spreading rumors about me, ain't trying to damage my name. You talk about things I've done in my head, but now I train. Why do you jump to conclusions and try to say I'm not safe? But you won't like it if I treat you the same. So please don't judge me, and I won't judge you. Cause I'm not looking, yeah, I do for them. So please don't judge me, and I won't judge you. Cause we all mistakes, but God has a lesson. I said God has a lesson, yeah, God has a lesson. I said God has a lesson, yeah, yeah.
Whatever, Maurice.
Whatever, man.
Aren't you going to get that?
No, I ain't going to get it.
Oh, really?
The problem is, Johnson, you know you got a new car, and she just don't recognize it. Where is you going?
I'm going to get the dog.
Where is you going?
You know what's wrong when she got that baby.
Answer my door, Paulette.
Why?
Don't answer my door. Child, I swear for Lord Jesus.
Come on in, girl.
Hey. I know y'all was not arguing in here, and I definitely know you won't sing it.
Trying to.
Ugh. Anyway, I just came to see if y'all wanted to hang out later, maybe go to the movies.
Trying to sign this cake, man.
I know. Mama's nagging, and she made me leave. I'm sorry, girl. I'm so sorry.
Paulette, you made this.
Yes, honey, I did.
You telling a lie, girl. This good right here, baby. Hey, Teresa, what did you say you want me and Paulette to go again tonight?
The movies.
To the movies? What?
Yeah, the movies.
Oh, man. But hey, look, look here, though. Who you bringing up, Teresa?
Chris McAdams, you know him?
Yeah, I know that dude. That's the cop, right? Hey, look, I'm gonna go put my nice clothes on. And then we can go, you know, we gonna party, baby. Hey. Hey.
I told you going to Miss Bumper's what you needed.
I know, this just feels so surreal.
I mean, do you think he gonna find out?
No, but he has proved me wrong before.
You're right, but I don't care as long as he go to the movies.
Church.
This house church has been around 20 years now.
Mm-hmm. You know what?
What's that?
I know the Lord is pleased with us, the work we're doing. You know, not only do we feed the people in need, but then, well, actually you, minister those in need too. A whole lot of people can join the church because of your ministry, and that's a blessing.
That is a blessing, Nancy. But I don't do this to get any praise now. It's not about me.
Well, listen, don't it make you feel good when the pastor acknowledges us in church on Sunday for the good deeds that we do?
Listen, it's not about me. It's about winning souls to Christ. You know, we should not go up and down bragging about ourselves. Listen, the Bible tells us in Proverbs 27:2, let another praise you, not your own mouth. Let another praise you, not your own lips, Bessie. Now, I'm not trying to get any glory. That's the wrong with people. That's what's wrong with people today, Bessie. People trying to get God's glory. They need to sit their hips down somewhere. Now, I'll tell you about me. All I want to do is to make it through those pearly gates. I'm not trying to get God's glory.
Well, I know I'm going through them pearly gates. Because I've been saved since I was 12 years old. I done saved every choir in church since I was 15. I done made Lord Jesus Christ my Savior.
Yeah.
I'm telling you the truth. I know I'm going through the gates. And besides, God wouldn't send a little lady like me to hell. And on top of all that, I don't sin.
What are you talking about? You don't sin, man. The Bible clearly tells us that if we say we don't sin, we deceive ourselves in the truth of this.
Let me tell you something. I think we just need to get ready and go over to church to feed these people because you about to start preaching up in here and I get enough from Reverend Powell on Sunday, honey.
Yeah, we better get ready to go because, you know, Diggy Coles is going to need our help set up because we're going to feed them from the church today and not going door to door. So let's go on over there, because I know we're going to have to clean up, do something.
Yeah, because you know what? That kitchen committee we got ain't hitting on nothing.
All right, then. Stop that now. Terrible stuff. Let me get my cousin.
All they want is some Zoom to phone.
It's really cold out there.
You know that's all they get? I'm telling you.
You drive or I drive?
You drive.
All right, then.
You know that way.
Dennis Riggs.
You know what it is.
It's going to be a crowd.
No one knew.
Mm.
You get to say,
Whew.
I don't know. Sometimes they don't know that this is Peggy doing that church today.
Hey!
Yeah.
been very, very verbally abusive to her. She thinks I'm forcing her to do
that. Yes. How do you know that, Bessie?
Because I saw Sister Stevens in the food line the other day, and she told me all about it.
You and Sister Stevens. All y'all do is go around talking about people's business all the time. You know the Bible tells us in Proverbs, do not go down as a tailbearer.
Amen.
And do not... and do not stand with blood against your neighbor's house.
Amen.
That's what the Lord says.
You know what? We need to get up here start cleaning this mess up,
because
otherwise
you're
going to
make
me feel guilty
for
not taking you
to confession. Well, I told my Lord Paulette, the Bible is made to express the poor leaving her. Let's get up here and get out of here and clean up this stuff.
Reverend Cole, we'll leave the rest of these dinners here, too, because somebody might go by a little bit later. Reverend Cole, Bishop Cole will help me out. You can depend on me.
That's right.
Dennis, you got to give it up. You got to give it up, Dennis. You got to get to give
Juan,
it up.
Juan, I said I'm not going. And you better stop quoting no dead gone scriptures at me.
Lower your voice, the child go here.
Oh, shit.
Get to know Jesus, Dennis, so we can walk in his name and prosper together.
You talk a whole
Jesus will forgive you for your sins. You just got to make him your personal savior and leave that Bible alone.
Stop quoting those scriptures at me, Juan. I don't believe in that man. God don't want me. I ain't nobody. It ain't nothing you can say to change my mind. Gone.
Dennis, you know Jesus loves you. Oh, look at my precious baby.
Looking good, boy. Okay. Looking good over there. Looking good. That's my son right there.
Are you ready, Daddy?
I'm sorry, son. I can't go.
But this is the only time we're going to be baptized.
I know, but I just can't go this time.
All you gonna do is shake and yell at my mama. You don't care about us.
What in the world wrong with that boy? See, that's what I'm talking about. That's the man I'm talking about right now, Juan. You messing my son up. You messing my son up.
Look what you have done.
No.
This is the only day he's gonna be baptized. And you come in here drinking. Then upset your son, Dennis. Dennis?
He done upset me.
Listen to me, Dennis. I'm worried about your soul, Dennis. I've tried to be a virtuous woman to you, but if you're going to reject Jesus, there's no way that this marriage is going to work. Amos 3 and 3 says, how? Look at me and tell me how, Dennis. How can two walk together unless they agree? We're not agreeing, Dennis.
Maybe I don't want to walk with you.
We're not agreeing. That's all right if you don't walk with me, but you better walk with Jesus. I don't want you to be left behind, Dennis. Make Jesus your choice. Isaiah 59 says, the Lord's hand is not short that it would not save, neither his ear heavy that it would not hear.
You ain't left yet.
Call on it.
You ain't left yet. Let the door hit you in the back.
Call John. Call John to get dressed and I expect to see you at church.
No, Chris will be here any minute.
Don't know Chris the cop?
Yes, Chris the cop.
You got a man, don't you?
No, I would never do that.
Why not?
Because he's not marriage material.
You're not marriage material?
Yes, of course.
Who's marriage material if I'm not?
Oh, hey, babe, I was just talking to Paulette.
Do you think I'm stupid?
What do you mean?
You've been playing me this whole time. You know, the guys at the PD warned me about you, Teresa. I didn't want to believe you. I believed in you, babe. They laughed at me and called me stupid when I told them I was dating you. I should have listened.
Chris, don't be ridiculous. None of those guys at the PD even know me.
Oh, they don't?
No.
What about Scott Turner, Randy Moore? And let's not forget Tom Wallace and James Boone. The end don't ring a bell to you. Do they, Teresa?
Look, Chris, you're not in this relationship by chance. You can leave there the door.
Isn't that easy, Teresa?
As easy as throwing this gun in my mouth.
After all we've been through.
Boy, I hope you didn't think this relationship was that serious. That's a joke. Get out of your feelings, Chris. I'm the best girlfriend you ever had. But you know what? Move on. Matter of fact, that little date we had with Maurice and Paulette later, you can leave. Don't worry about it.
You bragging about that too?
Oh yeah, I'm gonna find somebody else to go. You forgot who I was, right? Goodbye.
Yeah, I must have forgotten.
You must have. Coming up in here interrupting my favorite feud. You better go on.
All right,
Chris. Bye.
Hey, Everett.
Oh. Teresa. What's wrong with Chris? He didn't speak to me.
I don't know, Mama. We just broke up. Don't worry about it. Had to be on the wheels over Mama just.
What is usual? Normal. Just a dying story that did nothing. Ooh. What is wrong with you and Chris now?
Mama, I don't know. But you know what? You always told me my problem was still ill. So I'm going to call and tell me to see if you want to hang out.
Wait a minute. You know about that storm coming, don't you?
No, what storm?
Don't turn the television on Channel 6 News. There's a bad storm coming through here, girl.
America's East Coast gripped by a huge snowstorm expected to bring unprecedented disruption. Across a vast area, a state of emergency has been declared. Schools closed, flights cancelled, rail lines shut down, and people told to stay at home, all in anticipation of as much as 2 feet of snow.
We're seeing the everything line up for a major storm system affecting the eastern third of the country and affecting at least 50 million people with heavy snow, cold temperatures, and very strong winds.
Given the significant,
Oh my goodness, that's gonna be a bad storm. What are we gonna do these lights go out?
I don't know, Mama. What are we gonna do?
I tell you what, go in the back and pack us some overnight bags. Because we're gonna have to get up out of here. We gotta find somewhere else to go and stay.
You right, Mama.
Ooh, Lord have mercy. This weather is suffering. Ooh. Oh.
Hey, I'm not watching the news. I'm sitting here sewing. Why? What's on the news?
Girl, there's a bad storm coming. I mean, this thing is going to be terrible. I'm going to need you to come. Me and Teresa going to need you to come over to your house. But you got that great big old mansion over there. And this little old thing I live in, a tornado come through here, somebody turn it upside down. Let me ask you a question. Have you ever heard of snowstorms and tornadoes at the same time?
Y'all can come over here and stay.
But I'm not surprised by the weather matter.
I'm going to tell you one thing. I know God is tired of all of that abomination.
I hate to cut you off, but Teresa and I'll be over there a little bit, okay? I'll talk to you later.
All right, bye-bye.
All right, bye-bye.
Hello, Diane.
Hey there, Mama Jo.
Hi.
I guess you heard, huh?
Heard what?
That there's a bad storm coming.
Yeah, Bessie just told me.
You don't have any room over there for me and Wanda and Dennis Jr., do you?
Well, yes, y'all just come on over here.
Okay, well, we coming on because, you know, you got the generator, and if the lights go off, I can keep my insulin chill, you know I'm a diabetic, you know, and Wanda and Dennis having some problems, but I've been praying for them, you know. And anyway, we're going to come on over there, but are you sure? Are you sure, Mama Jo, it's okay for us to come over there and stay with you?
Diane, I'm very sure. Y'all come on over, and be careful on the road.
Okay, thank you so much. We'll be on over.
All right, take your time there. Be careful. Bye-bye.
Okay, we will. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye. Lord, I really better get up from here and fix some dinner. It's like a big cloud coming over here tonight. At least Mama Jo, Bessie and Diane and her crew. Go ahead and get something started here for dinner.
Come on in, Bessie.
Hey, Mom.
Hey, what? Hey. You want to ring the doorbell, please?
Bess, I don't stay here anymore, and I didn't want to be rude. Just come on in.
Well, get your head up and really close the door.
Hey, Miss Jones, how are you?
This one.
Beautiful.
Hey, Maurice.
How you doing?
I'm good. You know, everybody calls me Mom Jones. You can do the same thing. I know y'all must be a little nervous. You ready to start?
Uh-huh. Yes. That's what I'm talking about.
All right. Y'all just go on and have a seat over the phone. That's what I'm
going to say.
Show them what's in there and call it.
Mama, I need a favor.
What is that?
Well, you know this is supposed to be the worst storm in our history, and I was just wondering if Maurice could stay with us tonight?
You know, I really run a tight ship around here, baby. But he can't stay in your brother Cabin's hotel room since the storm is coming.
Oh, that's fine. I understand.
All right, very good. All right, now I'm going to get the dinner ready. Just sit down and entertain my niece.
Okay.
All right. Can I run the call, please?
Yes, Mom.
Hey, Mom Jo.
Hey, Bessie. How you doing this evening?
I'm doing good. Ooh. What you doing? You always doing something. Don't you ever get tired.
Bessie, God has given me life and strength, and I just keep on going until he says stop.
Oh,
you know, Sister Diane is coming over here today, too.
Oh, Jesus.
Yeah, she's coming. She'll be here today.
Hey, Mama Jo, is there anything you need me to do?
I'm going to have to switch the kitchen. But why don't you go ahead and call that straight up that
house? I try.
Thank you.
All right. Go that way. get the door for you, Mama Jo.
Thank you so bad.
Yeah.
What is
about two or three years?
We've been together 3 years.
Something like that. When y'all get married?
What is she doing, Mama? Writing a book? I'm sure they don't want you all in their business.
All I did was ask a question.
You're always asking questions.
Y'all calm down. Look at here. I think I'm going to have a date for you real soon, Miss Bessie. Mm. You know, I'm going to put a ring on that thing right there. I got you.
All right. Shut up.
Hold up, be my business.
How you doing, Mom?
Well, Mom, how you doing?
Doing fine.
It's so good to see you.
What y'all doing here tonight? Y'all having a party or something?
Yeah.
No, sir, we're not having a party right here. The storm is coming.
That's right.
Yeah, the storm is coming. Everybody's here for one reason or another. You don't want to have a lot in the house that either.
No, that's right.
Everybody out here. I hope you're hungry.
You know me, Mom. I'm always hungry.
I got your place to dinner.
Hey there, boy.
Y'all ready to eat?
Yes, ma'am.
I said, hey there, boy.
How you doing?
All right.
Doing all right.
Yes,
best.
Yes, fine.
What's up, bro?
I'll get it for you.
What's going on, right?
Well, a lot of people coming over tonight.
What's going on with you?
What's going on here?
One over here.
Wanda, it's Dennis when he's all spanking, sir.
Thank you, Paula.
You can. He's
so stupid. What are you doing here?
Wanda, there's a bad storm coming, and I want you and Dennis Jr. home with me.
No, sir.
It's a
drink
again. I can smell it. What is the time to have here?
Wanda, don't make me drag you about this house.
Thank you for getting everybody together in one of those Lord's buildings. Save the storm. storm like your son Jesus did. In the name of Jesus, peace be still. And Lord, I ask you to bless this food and let it nourish each and every body that's here tonight. It's in your son Jesus' name, my friend. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Thank you.
Amen. Y'all can eat.
Hey. Chicken.
Y'all come over here to the place.
Ladies first, Maurice.
Teresa, fix your mama plate.
Okay,
fix mama plate, baby.
Who are you? Who are you? Who is this coming over here to mama house looking like this?
I don't know.
Mom, what did I tell you the other day?
That's my friend from down the road.
Mom.
Don't worry about it, mama. I handle this. Don't worry about it.
You can give him a tape. I'm not eating a mac and cheese. Teresa. Baby, I need a napkin and a fork, baby.
Look at that old crack in the street.
Thank you, darling.
Oh.
I don't know what to say.
A G? I'm a G.
Look at that old crack in
the street. Hey,
Mom. Mom, come on now.
No,
oh, y'all done messed up now. Y'all a little cracky.
We just
need to get it.
Yeah, y'all
a
little
cracky. Get
out of here.
Get out of
here.
Spicy chicken.
You need something for the crack here and get it off.
Yes.
Okay.
Show your manners.
All right.
You don't fix my flavor.
Who is this?
I'll get it for you, Mama.
Thank you, Teresa. They look like everybody's both pieces of money. I'm going to tell you the truth. What are you doing?
Hey, what's up, Chris? How you doing?
That's you, Mom.
Yes, I'm Mark
Jones. Mark's my son. What do you want, Mark?
What is that?
What did he do? What do you want?
I'm looking for Mark Jones.
Uh-uh, I don't have to know him yet. Don't take him.
Mark.
Mark Jones, who under
what?
You understand the rights I've given you in the world.
She snitched on me.
That's right.
Sometimes the storm can lose something that you really know. I talk to my children, scriptures and Bible verses, they know the right way. I raise the right. Oh, yeah.
You sure do.
You're home, Granger.
Yes, ma'am.
But you know, he's going to be all right.
Well, Mama, should we go down there and bail him out?
No. He's not a baby anymore, lady. He is a grown man. I just pray the something that I told Mark is going to keep him in the grounds of God.
Don't get yourself somewhere and sit down before you get lost.
Turn his way back to the Lord. You'll be all right. Come on, y'all. Eat your food before you go.
Yeah, he got something down there getting straight.
Good.
You done ate everything.
I didn't mean him as best.
Give me that, Mama.
Okay. You better get your boyfriend.
Oh. When do I get my phone call tonight? I'm afraid we won't get the phone call until the morning. Look, this isn't my first rodeo. I don't know that I'm supposed to get a phone call tonight. Seems to me you like bragging on the side you got with this. Maybe I am. What is it to you? Nothing.
I just gave
you a cookie. 22 rap sheet, this is your third strike. And you, that's 25 years plus in federal prison. And you think about that, Mr. Mark Jones.
Where
you going, huh? Where you?
Thank you so much.
Drugs for a long time. I mean, I'm 28 right now. I've been doing drugs I know since I was 15.
Do you know the man named Jesus?
No. Who is that?
Jesus is an innocent man that died for your sins. They took a crown of thorns and pushed it down on his head
and the blood came streaming down. And that blood was streaming down because God knew that we, people would touch things or think things that they could not be in connection with Him. So He stretched His hands out wide, and the blood came streaming down, and they nailed Him to the cross. And that blood was because God knew that people would be touching things that they should not be touching. And then they nailed His feet to the cross. The blood came streaming down from there. God knew people would be going places that they should not be going. And then they pierced Him in the side. When they pierced Him in the side, blood came streaming down. And that's what makes us whiter than snow. Ask God to come into your heart. Tasha?
I'm scared, Mama Jo. All I know how to do is survive in the streets. Why would Jesus want to save somebody like me? My own mama gave me away. And my daddy, I don't even know the man. I gotta survive. You see, and them drugs I be taking, they ease the pain. The pain that I feel. They help me.
For how long, Tasha? Not long, I'm sure. You know that pain that you're feeling in your heart right now? Jesus can take it all away. The pain of how your mother left you and how you never knew your father, Jesus can take that away. You know in John chapter 12, verses 44 to 50, Jesus cried out and said, "He who believes in me believes in the one that sent me. And he who sees me sees the one that sent me. I am come as a light unto the world. He who believes in me will not walk in darkness. I have come as a light." And God said, "I am not come to judge the world, but I have come that the world might be saved through me. He who does not believe in me, the same will be judged in the end. My Father gave me a commandment, what I should say and what I should speak. And so what He tells me to say, I say. And what He tells me to speak, I speak." Do you believe, Tasha?
Yes, I believe.
Very good, sweetie. Now, all you have to do is look forward and don't look back. Walk with God, hand in hand. Let Him guide you. He's got a purpose for you, Tasha. He knew you before you were formed in your mother's womb. You have worth, honey. You're worthy to God. He knew you were worth saving.
So what you're saying is, He died because He knew my worth.
Yes, that's what I'm saying.
So I'm worthy.
You're worthy, and you have received us. You have received Him. Worth saving. Thank you, God, for saving Tasha. Welcome to the kingdom.
Yes, I got saved.
Everything is fine, Bessie.
Yeah, I can show you. I did. She's saying she's the speak Jesus Christ as the Lord and Savior.
Okay.
Isn't that a blessing? Mm-hmm. Oh, God is so good. She's saved.
Amen.
Yeah, she's saved. Thank you, Lord. She's saved.
Thank you.
You're a
You go with your daddy.
I'll see y'all in the morning.
I don't know
okay.
if you're sitting with him or not.
Good night. Good night, everybody. Good night.
That's odd. Normally, Mama's up cooking breakfast by now. Let me go check on her.
Store, right? Come on, look, look, come on.
Mama.
No, come on.
No.
Just sit down.
No.
Okay? Sit down. It's all right. She's just at the store.
Not all right.
It is. No. I don't know, man.
Mama Joe is gone.
What do you mean, gone, Paulette?
I went to go check on her because normally she's up cooking breakfast by now, and all that was there was her clothes.
Well, let me go see if Wanda seen her because it's too early in the morning.
No.
Just
no.
It's all right.
It's not all right. Oh, my God.
Wyman Dennis Jr. are gone, too.
Oh,
this is all
that ashes
and
clothes. Clothes.
Where are
they?
What are you talking about,
Mama Jo is gone.
What's wrong now?
I went to go check on her because normally she's up cooking breakfast. By now, she's gone.
Oh, calm down. She probably just went
to the store. No, Mrs. Jackson, you know my mama wouldn't go to the store and buy no food. She would cook it.
Yeah, that's true.
Oh, my gosh. Wait. She told me this day was going to come, and I was going to look for her, and she would be gone.
What are you talking about, Paulette?
What are you talking about?
She said the rapture was going to come, and she was going to be caught up in the air with Jesus and gone, and I was going to look for her. She would be gone. Oh, my gosh.
Paulette, you can just calm yourself.
Miss Beth, no! If this is a Jesus rapture, why are you still here? Why didn't you get to go? Why were you left behind?
Let me tell you, there ain't no rapture. I'm not going to stop. When the rapture comes, I'm going to be up there to stop. So you just be calm. Up in ratchet, up in
style. Oh, no, we've been left behind.
I didn't really know what Juan is. I'm looking for Juan.
Mom,
you got to get there. Say something, say it is up.
He didn't sing that Eric Watts.
That's right.
I know, I don't know what she's talking about. Come on, Mama. Get yourself worked up. Come on, sit down. Well, come on, sit down.
We're going to be all right. We're going to be all right.
You know what?
Oh, you're right. to let you run. You turned her away. You joined heaven with one of your sons, your wife. You were verbally abusive to your wife. Your wife tried to mess you the word. You told her to stop. I tried to come into your life, but you rejected. I visited you in your dreams several times. I told you what I wanted you to do. Yet still, you rejected. I cared more about what you thought than what I wanted. You are a very selfish man.
Yes, Lord. All these things you say are true, Lord. But Lord, I believe that. I believe that you are the Son of God. If you give me one last chance, or one last chance, I will do your will. I will do whatever you ask me to do.
Is Dennis Moore's name listed in the last book of life?
No, Lord. Oh, no. It's not here.
Dennis Morris, depart from me now. God, know you not, you work of iniquity. Judgment has been set. That's the world's name. This is the last one. to alone? Apart from me now, God knows you're not your work of iniquity.
No!
Judgment has been set.
No!
You have 5 weapons and a host of male friends in front of you. You introduced your best friend, Paulette, to witchcraft. And you deep down was wrong. You ran from my word. You embraced sin and were untouchable. You continued to your best friend. Teresa Willow, depart from me now, for I know you not to work with it. Judgment has been set. Maurice White, please come forward. You had to see with Paulette while she wanted to be there. You continue to be a woman. You ran from the truth. Your mother tried to have a conversation with you about repentance, but you ignored her. Instead, you see you have a time of honor, but you never see her. I was calling you to my will, but you didn't want to turn from the real place. Paulette Jones, man, thoughts. Depart from me now, for I know you're not worth it. Just as we said.
Mama Jeff, that was your last call. You accept.
Jason. For that, you shine. Ms. Tasha Allen's name.
Thank you. But before I get started, I want to let you guys know that we went through so much to perform with you. And also, I want you to know how the devil rolled us to get to where we are, but we got the victory tonight. And also, to let you know, we never practiced on stage. We never got that chance. But look at the Holy Ghost. Can you see him? When you have him in your life, honey, he's a teacher. He does it all. But let's introduce the cast real quick so I can get out of your way. I always like to do, I know most people who do plays, they don't give their cast anything. But I feel like giving them something, you know, to let them know I appreciate them. Because it takes a crew to make it happen. You know what I'm saying? So I'm going to start introducing the cast. Doris Brandon. I want y'all to come out and take your bows and go back to the front, okay? Doris Brandon, she played Wanda. Jamel Jackson Jr., he played Wanda's son. And also, he's my son. Next, we have Bianca Newman. She played Paulette Jones. Camilla Wallerton, she played Bessie. Jared Graves, he played Mark Jones, who's also my husband. Joseph Harrison, he played Satan, and he also played Chris the Cop. Jackie Morris, she played Sister Diane. Yeah. the lovely band that we have tonight, and especially the Daniel Hardy. We honor you guys tonight for the hard work and dedication to make this play job and a possible performance. God bless you guys. I'm sorry to keep you so long, but I hope you enjoyed the show.
Hello, everyone. Good Lord, we had so much fun. It was a blessing doing this play for you guys. I hope you guys enjoyed it. Listen, if you need me to write you a play for your church, your organization, or even put on the play that you just seen, just give me a call at 434-471-0053. We're all in kingdom building status. We're just trying to save souls to Christ and add to the kingdom. Again, like us on Facebook, God's Plan Drama Ministries, or call us again at 434-471-0053. We love you. God bless.